Now, the investigator seized the iPhone in question on December 3rd. The FBI reached out to Apple for assistance on December 5th. Apple started providing the FBI with information, with account information I gathered the same day. But then the next day, on December 6th, at the instruction of the FBI, San Bernardino County changed the password to the iCloud account associated with that device. They did so without consulting Apple, at the instruction or suggestion of the FBI, and changing that password foreclosed the possibility of an automatic backup that would have allowed Apple to provide you with this information without bypassing its own security, and thus necessitated in the first place the application to the court that you made and that we're discussing today. In other words, if the FBI hadn't instructed San Bernardino County to change the password to the iCloud account, all this wouldn't have been unnecessary, and you would have had that information. So my question is, why did the FBI do that?
I do think, as I understand from the experts, there was a mistake made in that 24 hours after the attack, where the county, at the FBI's request, took steps that made it impossible later to cause the phone to back up again to the iCloud. The experts have told me I'd still be sitting here. I was going to say fortunately, I'm glad I'm here, but we would still be in litigation because the experts tell me there's no way we would have gotten everything off the phone from a backup. I have to take them at their word, but that part of your premise of your question is accurate.